Hello everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Fire Emblem. Liquid Cosmic here, and in the last episode, we took on... This time, we're doing Chapter 1. And we have our story so far and everything. So yeah, I kind of apologize. I didn't realize that my prologue ended up being 20 minutes long. I just kind of, you know, started talking and stuff about... you know, the game, because, you know, it is important to know what everything means, so I just figure that, look at that, there's like a speck on my screen here, gotta fix that. So admittedly, the last many times I've played this game, I've skipped the dialogue, and I've kind of gotten in the habit of skipping the dialogue, and I don't really plan on reading the dialogue, because you can read that yourself. But yeah, we're meeting some new characters here. This guy is one of my favorites in this game. This is Sane, and he is just a total lecher, you know? Lecher. Jeez. So yeah, he's just basically a total perv, and it's pretty funny. The game kind of hates him too. And this chapter, like, pretty much every chapter in Lin's mode, on normal mode, is, you know, it's pretty tutorial-based. But when you're playing through the tutorials, you have a lot of scripted battles and stuff, and the game just really hates Sane. He forgets to get equipment and stuff like that. So in this episode, there's gonna be a few more things that I'm going to have to, explain. But I'll explain them pretty much as we go on. Because, you know... it's kind of annoying having the tutorial windows pop up, so I think I can do a decent job explaining it. So, yeah. And then this other guy is Kent, and he's the other knight. And now this is actually kind of a tradition in the Fire Emblem games. In every game, with very few exceptions, you always start with a red knight and a green knight. If you don't start with them, they join very early on. The thing that's different about Sane and Kent is that their statistical archetypes have kind of been reversed, and I'll show you what I mean in a second. Oh, this guy's... uh-oh. He looks kind of like a thug. An absolute tool. You can tell by the scar in the 5 o'clock shadow that he's gotta be a bad guy. Time to die, darling. What a weird translation. At least it's not, like, going out of its way to avoid saying the word die, or death, or anything. So yeah, these guys look like... well, they're gonna help us out here, of course, because every character with a unique palette, you know, they've got to be a good guy if they're not a boss. So yeah, and we've got some fight with some bandits, but they're gonna help us, which I said already. Yeah, so they're just gonna help us out. I think we get the point. So these guys, Sane and Kent, are a new class. They're the Cavalier class, and the Cavalier class is, it's kind of up to the, they don't really specialize in one thing, put it that way. Unlike Lin, who of course gets a lot of speed and skill and stuff, just by the fact that she's, you know, a lightly armored sword unit. These guys are pretty variable, and they depend on the character themselves. Now, typically in Fire Emblem games, the Red Knight gets a lot of strength, and the Green Knight gets a lot of speed early on, a lot of speed and skill. But in this game, they actually reverse the archetype, and even though Kent is the Red Knight, he's the one who gets more speed and skill, and Sane gets a lot of strength. Which is actually kind of cool. Now see, unfortunately, in this game, in hard mode, Sane only has an iron lance. Now, and this brings up something called the weapon triangle, which is basically just sort of a rock, paper, scissors. You can see the red arrow pointing down by Sane's lance. Well, that means that he gets deductions. And likewise, the bandit with the arrow pointing up, he gets bonuses. So he's gonna get, I believe it's a 15% increase to hit. Well, I get a 15-point deduction to hit. I also get a point deduction to the strength, and he gets a point to his strength. So I'm just kind of hoping here that... okay, good. Also, about some statistical growths. I was correct about Lynn's strength growth. It is 40%, just like I thought it was. Her HP growth is 70%, her skill and speed are both 60%, luck is 55, defense is 20, and resistance is 30. As you can see, obviously her defense is pretty weak. But she does have rather phenomenal skill and speed. Kent's stats are 85% HP, 40% strength, 50% skill, 45% speed, 20% luck, 25% defense, and 25% resistance. Sane, on the other hand, has 80% HP, a whopping 60% strength, but only 35% skill, 40% speed, which is pretty decent actually, 35% luck, and 20% defense and resistance. Now, it kind of comes up to personal preference, honestly, whether or not you choose to use Sane or Kent. Personally, I like Sane more, and there are some things that Kent does much, much, much better than Sane. Most notably, the fact that he has a better affinity for getting supports, and a better kind of support pool in general, but that's something that we'll bring up much later. Not until we start the main story. But basically, Sane is a Wind Affinity character, and Wind Affinity kind of sucks. Whereas Kent has the Anima Affinity, which is one of the best affinities in the game. Because it's basically these affinities, when they get supports, are going to... Okay, this is bad. This is really bad right here. Yeah, down to 1 HP. I try not to use the characters that I don't use, or that I don't plan on using as much, so... And this is just kind of how I play the game. I realize that there are better ways to do it, but this is just kind of how I've always done it, and, old habits die hard, I guess you could say. Now, the other thing important to note about this is you can see all these, like, forest panels. Well, you can see in the lower left corner that when you're standing on a forest panel, you get one extra point of defense and 20 extra points to avoid, which is rather nice. So... be sure to take advantage of that if you can. But more importantly, you don't want to let your enemies take advantage of that. Yeah, Sane gets beat up pretty badly here in the tutorial. I believe what happens is he starts not having a sword and insists on using the lance because it's more heroic or something like that. And then he tries to attack a bandit and misses. So Kent gives him an extra sword, and then he goes to attack a bandit that's on a forest space, and he still misses. And he's just like, jeez, man. So Sane gets pretty unlucky, and then you have to trade him a vulnerary. There's one other command here, which is the trade command, and you kind of already saw me use that, but you can swap items between characters with the trade command right here. So if I did want to give Sane a vulnerary, I could just stick it in this spot right there, but I don't really need it, so... Yep. And we're just about to take on the boss, and then... Oh, I thought he would move. This is hard mode, after all. Yeah, we should be good here. As for the battle animations, I'm not always going to have these turned on. In these early chapters, though, when I need, like, padding for stuff to talk about, I mean, just, you know, sure, why not keep them on, you know? But, definitely later in the game, where you start to have, like, hordes of enemies attacking you, I'm gonna turn it off, because it'll just take way too long. And also, I do plan on doing both Elowood and Hector's story, and showing both of... Well, obviously showing both of them. If I'm gonna do both of them, you're gonna show both of them. So, that's just, you know, if I have animations turned on for both of them, it's just gonna take forever. I'm probably gonna turn it off for Hector's mode, just because there are more enemies and more chapters in Hector's mode. And then Elowood's mode will be the main thing. My plan is to actually get... Oh, well, that was a shit level up. But that's okay. I'm not sure if I'm going to use Sane the whole way. Yeah, I do have a plan worked out for everything. And as you can see, we get another CG cutscene here. What you'll find with these little CG pictures is that you're going to see a lot of them really early on in the game through Lynn's story. And then you'll see one, like, pretty early on, and then you won't see, like, any of them, like, for a really long time. And to get some of them, you actually have to go through some pretty ridiculous requirements, which I will be covering. There's one chapter, if you've played the game before, you know what I mean. One chapter that is really hard to get to, and you have to get it if you want to see all the CG pictures. So, yeah, and basically this is just all talking about Lynn's backstory, about how her mother was a royalty, and then she eloped with a nomad to the plains, where she basically became, you know, a plains woman, and that's where Lynn was born, and that's why she's been here on the plains and everything, so... Yep. And she died. Ooh. But wait, we already knew that. Guess it's not that big of an emotional impact. So yep, Lynn has indeed been living alone on the plains, but these guys are gonna take us back to Lycia, and that'll be Lynn's story, basically. Lynn's story is really short. It's only 10 chapters long, and it's really, like I've said countless times before, it's just an introduction. So yeah. Yeah, also strange. Now, something else that's kind of cool about this game is that the characters blink and change their facial expressions, which they didn't do in the previous game, and it looked really strange, especially after playing this one. Their mouths just moved up and down, and it was really dumb-looking. So, yeah, Lundgren. Obviously the bad guy. With a name like Lundgren, you've got to be a bad guy. So. Yep. She's gonna have to take up the title so that Lundgren doesn't rule over his people with an iron fist. Yeah. And this story is only 10 chapters long. I think I mentioned that before, but I can't remember, so I might as well say it anyway. You want me to decide. So yeah, we're just gonna stay with Lynn, because she's nice. Okay, here. And that makes us done with chapter 1. So yeah. Next time on Let's Play Fire Emblem, we take on Chapter 2. This is Liquid Cosmic. Bye.